We're on to One Thing by One Direction, the second part. We're on to the chorus now. If you haven't learned the verse and the bridge, please go back to video number one and then come back here. And let's assume you've done that, and we're going to go on to the chorus. Now, first of all, you'll notice on your PDF file that you've got a brown D, a blue G, a brown A, a blue D, brown B minor, blue G, and so on. And next to that, it says chorus strumming, and you'll see the count of one and two and is in brown, and the count of three and four is in blue. Okay, what's happening over here is you've got two chords for each bar. So slow motion, one and two and three and four. We got that. One more time through, one and two and three and four. And if I bring in the strumming hand so you can see the movement and the changes with the strumming, we're going to have this first two chords again, two, three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and four. After that, A to D, one, and two, and three, and four. So they're really quick changes as we go through it. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the back track now from the end of the bridge. So you're going to hear B minor going, two and three and four and then I'm going to start strumming along with the chorus. Are you ready for this? Here we go. Two, three, four and one thing and. That's your song. Now let's just break it down slowly. You're going to get left and right hand together, and I want you to play along with me here. First line, first of all, D to G, A to D. So slow motion, D, G, A, D. Your turn with me. One, two, three, four, and one, two, and three, and four, and one, and two, three, and four. Now, remember in the first video also I said there's two ways to play A. You can play A like that, that's the traditional way, but lots of other guitarists like swapping fingers 1 and 2, clearly numbered, around. So finger 1 comes down, middle finger goes up. And the reason why I personally like this one is because I'm changing so often from D to A and A to D for this song. Watch my finger when I change to D. Did the first finger move? Not really. So the advantage of this is it lets my first finger keep my positioning. So it means I don't move the hand around. That's very, very important. The whole way through the song, you don't really want your thumb doing this and that and then disappearing and coming back or anything strange like that. Try and keep your thumb in one place, and you may pivot it. So you can sort of roll in it a little bit like that, as long as it doesn't do that. And especially as long as it doesn't do that. And I actually had one student that did that. Please don't do that. Okay. Second line, we're going to have four chords again. This time, instead of going D, G, A, D, it goes B minor, G, A, D. So it's a very cleverly written song. They've taken four chords and they've changed the sequence the whole way through to make it more interesting. So your second line is going to go 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and. Should we try that? First and second line together. So it's D to G, A goes to D, then B minor to G, and A to D again. Are we ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, and 2, 3, and 4, and that last up over there that I put in, that actually wasn't intentional, but I thought I'd leave it in and not redo the video to show you that an extra strum can sound quite cool. So if you add an extra up strum at the end of the bar, in other words, after the four on that and, four and, if you do that, go for it, it sounds cool. Now third line, D to G, same as the first line, and then the A to B minor. So there's the change this time. So every time, some little changes inside there. And we're now going to do all three lines. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, and 3, and 4, and 1, 2, and 4, and 1, 2, and 3, and 4. getting quite easy now, you're getting the idea. Fourth line, two G's in a row. Normally you'd only write down one G, but I decided to put the second one inside it just to show that the G goes for the full bar. One, two, and three, and four, and then A to D. And again, you've got the B minor stop, dead silence, and then he sings one thing at the end of that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to play it the whole way through from the very beginning of the track with the audio track that you're going to be playing along with as well. So we're going to do everything from the beginning, two verses, bridge, chorus, and this is what I'd like to get back from you, but only you playing through with the audio track. Let's do it from the beginning. Second verse. Also, if you listen carefully or watch the video carefully, you can actually see that we're putting that extra and every now and then for the bridge and the chorus. So this is what I've written down on a G chord, for example. One, two, and three, and four. And this is the extra and that you can include. One, two, and three, and four, and. So that last up strum, if you want to put it in now and then, sounds cool, will work, go for it. Hope you have lots of fun with the song. Any questions, please, you have my WhatsApp details. Love to hear from you. And I'd also really like to see a video of you playing it. I want to see your strumming techniques. You don't have to use a pick. You can strum fingers like this. I don't really mind. And if you do strum with fingers, you'll notice I use my first finger like that. So it's almost like a car's windscreen wiper. And that's the windshield. That movement. But fingers or pick, not important. And enjoy the song. I want to see your hand movements. Hope they're nice and clear. You can use a bar chord if you want to. Have fun with the song. It's a good one.